hear me out. I'm not saying you're doing Notion wrong. You're fine. Like, you're totally fine, but what you're doing is probably wrong because you're probably making one of these three mistakes right now that you could not. You just could not be making that mistake. But you know what? Maybe you just didn't know. So I'm here to inform. Granted, there's a little bit of satire in the way I'm saying it, but you know, there's some things that you could fix. In all seriousness, if you go into your Notion and you're like me and have a bunch of different covers that are the same, I would actually recommend that you maybe go through and remove them. Because if you notice, it saves a lot of nice space. And when toggling between different pages, you're actually getting a better experience because you don't have to scroll down every time. It's a little bit gratuitous to have the exact same cover image every single time, and especially on the mobile experience. I do not have a cover on these because I can quickly and easily see everything rather than having a cover, which takes up a huge amount of page space on the mobile experience. Now, another thing that people don't realize is that there are a lot of dead properties that you probably have and never use anymore. And it's actually really okay to get rid of the properties because, for example, this could be a dead property here, dead property, as in something you just don't use. Like, it's there, it exists, but the purpose of it existing is extremely gratuitous and you've just not used it at all. You know, if you delete this, it's totally okay. It saves on clutter. And the reason I recommend you do that is because just like how there's a bunch of hidden properties here, if you go into this database, so if I go into the three dots here, go to properties, scroll to the bottom, you actually can see every single deleted property, and you can obviously delete them permanently here, but there's no reason not to just put them in there to get them stored in a way that is less cluttered for the way that you're viewing things. In that same line of thinking, we have way too many databases. I came across this the other day, and my daily highlight and journal essentially, this is a place where I figure out the best thing I want to get done today. What is it? And then I end up making the journal the exact same name as it. And then I put a relation between these two for whatever reason and have the same name here. So back to recording would be my daily highlight. And then like I go through here, paste this here, and then I sync the two. And then this roll up is pulled from the journal. But I could just make the journals and the daily highlight the exact same thing. I already do this with stuff like my this week formula. So all I'd have to do was rip this week formula, add a new linked database for my journal. I actually even already have the day of the week here. So this tells you how silly I was beforehand. Move this into a board view, group by day of the week, sort by, do manual, change the card size to small, properties, add a checkbox property to it, hide the empty ones because obviously if it doesn't have a day, it's not there. Remember what days go in what order of the week as humans usually have to deal with in their life, and then filter it to this week is. And then obviously since I've done this year over year, what I'd then have to do would be go in and make a property for this year, change this to Y, make some adjustments there, then just add this to an advanced filter, combine the two, and now I have one database instead of two. Because you know what? You need less than you think, but you do need to check out more of these videos on how to improve your Notion even more.